Hey there, so there's something called the fractionally sized box, which is a widget that can help you control the layout of the elements or the size of the elements in a relative way. Kind of like the media query, you use percentages instead of fixed values. So, you know, it's always valuable to know about these kinds of widgets. In this case, what you're seeing right here, this is a list tile, except I made it just 70% of the available space. And then these two elements are separated also by a fractionally sized box. And also this button right here without the size box would be much smaller because the text isn't too long, but I made it a little bit longer as well. In fact, it's the exact same size as the list tile. And I also placed it on the bottom right of the container using alignment. So if you want to learn how to do this, just stick around and watch the video until the very end. So here we are, and the first thing I'm going to do with the fractionally sized box is I'm going to create a little bit of space between these two elements right here, and let's just go for 20%, why not? So fractionally sized box, and then you just need to access the height factor property right here, and I said 20%, so let's put in 0.2, add this comma right here, and I'm gonna save and just watch what happens. It crashes. Why did it crash? Because if you're using this within a column or a row, which let's face it, you'll very likely do that, the best thing that you could do is just wrap it in a flexible widget. You can also do it with an expanded widget, but then, you know, you'll expand to occupy as much space as possible, and that's not really what we want to do, at least not here. So I'm just gonna go ahead and just use flexible. And there it is, that's 20%. And you might be wondering, 20% of what? Basically, it's 20% of all the available space. That's what the fractionally sized box does. It takes all the available space, it comes up with the amount that it is, and then you just use the percentages to define it. Like, for example, you have this list tile right here, and as always, list tiles go all the way from the beginning of the screen to the end, but we want to give it some margin on the sides, so let's just go ahead and use a fractionally sized box yet again. And this time we're going to use a width factor, and let's just do 0.7. Because what you're doing here is you're telling the child of the fractionally sized box, in this case, it's the list tile right here, you're telling it to have 70% of the available space. That's the size that you're giving the list tile. And you know, I'm gonna hit this the save button and you're gonna realize what it is. As you can see, this is essentially 70% of the available space. Meaning this right here is 15% and this is 15%, so that's the remaining 30%. This is basically kind of like using a media query, but you know, sometimes it's much faster to just type in fractionally sized box and just give it a width factor. And it also works with buttons, of course. I can just wrap this with a fractionally sized box. And then, for example, in this case, if I give it 0.7, the button will actually increase in size because it's smaller than that. So now it's the exact same size as the list tile. And if you want to define where it goes, you can also use the alignment property. I know the fractionally sized box actually comes with an alignment property, but usually you just wrap it with a container or an alignment widget or whatever, and then you give it the alignment like that. We have a container right here, so let's just go for it. I'm gonna just give it a color so we can see the container, and let's give it a height and fix this right here. Hit save. And right now the button is taking up the whole container, but if we give it an alignment, like let's just send it to the bottom right, for example. And now I'm gonna save, and the button is going to go back to its normal size, and it's going to be placed on the bottom right. So this is essentially it. I encourage you to try it out yourself, but you know, it's basically just an easier way than media query to make your dimensions relative to the available space, you know? Obviously, it's always better to choose percentages rather than fixed values, so this is a very useful little widget sometimes. So just try it out yourself, and you'll see for yourself that it can be very useful. That's about it for today. If this helps you at all, please leave me a like and subscribe if you want to keep on learning about Flutter. Thank you so much for watching. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.